Regular expression is as powerful as a finite state automaton. So if something is as powerful as some other concept, typically it means you can transform one into the other, which is here the case between regular expression and FSA. Here we see a regular expression over here, which looks rather complicated, and we see a corresponding finite state automaton. Both match the language that is binary numbers that are multiples of 3. In our FSA, we have here the last n state as 0. So how can we come from one regular expression like this to this machine, or from this machine to this regular expression? So let's get started from a regular expression. If we have a regular expression like this, what you need to do, you need to read the symbols, and the symbols are non-terminals, so they become a transition, directly a transition, like 0 becomes a transition 0. So then if we have some x or y, we have two transitions from the same state. And star, in fact, creates a cycle. Now what you need to do is, well, these are simple rules. You need to apply them from this regex and try, think a little bit about it. Then you come up with this machine. So the opposite is true when you come from a finite state automaton. Then you can create, of course, the regular expression. All you need to do is to create a regular expression for every path from the start to a terminal state. So here we have only one terminal state, so we have to look where, how can we get to this state? Yeah, for example, 0 as many times as we like will lead to a valid word, accepted word. So our regular expression has somehow 0 star in it, which is what we see here in this case. So here's now a little task for you. Try to create a regular expression for the given automaton, which is here. And T1 is the terminal state. So all you have to do is you have to look for all paths from the start, which is this state, how to you can reach T1. Think about it a little moment. How can you go and reach T1 from this state? Dot indicates any kind of symbol. Recall this. And yeah, the answer should be not so complicated in this case, because this is a rather simple machine. Pause the video, think about it. Welcome back. So we have to construct a path to T1. So how do we do that? Well, we have to read through the edge A. With A, we can reach T1. That makes sense, right? However, from T1, we can read dot and then another A, and we are still at T1 again. And we can repeat this as many times as we like, this kind of cycle. So that means it's going to be a star. So that means the resulting regex will be A, and then we have the group dot A star. So again, with A you get to T1, and then from T1 you can cycle as long as you like. So now we should create the regular expression for this extended automaton here. Here we have two terminal states, T1 and T2. And the idea how to create a regular expression is look how you can reach one of those two states separately, and then create a regular expression and combine them using our OR in a regular expression. Okay, pause now the video, think about this little task, and yeah, I will reveal the solutions in a second. So I hope you had a little success. So this is now a bit more complicated. What we already knew is that A and then the group dot A star will lead to this, to the end T1. And then it's clear from the start state, if you follow the edge B and C, we also at T2. So B and C. However, what you may have missed is that you need to construct a path as well from T1 to T2. So someone could start from here, follow A, he or she is at T1 now, and now reads dot again follows as many times dot A as this person likes, and finally reads another dot, getting out to this dot state again, and then reading B and C and getting to T2. So that's basically what we see here. So we can follow the cycle A dot star times, right? So we can cycle here as many times as we like. We will be back at this state, then reading B and C, and that's it. And then we have to combine it with OR, and we are done.